which once charmed her soul, now grates harshly upon her ear. The ballroom has lost its charms, and with wasted health and embittered heart she turns away with the conviction that earthly pleasures cannot satisfy the longings of the soul. And so forth and so on. There was a buzz of gratification from time to time during the reading, accompanied by whispered ejaculations of, "How sweet! How eloquent! So true!" etc., and after the thing had closed with a peculiarly afflicting sermon, the applause was enthusiastic. Then arose a slight, melancholy girl, whose face had the interesting paleness that comes of pills and indigestion, and read a poem. Two stanzas of it will do. A Missouri maiden's farewell to Alabama. Alabama, goodbye. I love thee well, but yet for a while do I leave thee now. Sad, yes, sad thoughts of thee my heart doth swell, and burning recollections throng my brow, for I have wandered through thy flowery woods, have roamed and read near Tallapoosa's stream, have listened to Tallahassee's warring floods, and wooed on Coosa's side Aurora's beam. Yet shame I not to bear an o'erful heart, nor blush to turn behind my tearful eyes. 'Tis from no stranger land I now must part, 'tis to no stranger's left I yield these sighs. Welcome and home were mine within this state, whose vales I leave, whose spires fade fast from me, and cold must be mine eyes and heart and tête, when, dear Alabama, they turn cold on thee. There were very few there who knew what tête meant, but the poem was very satisfactory, nevertheless. Next appeared a dark-complexioned, black-eyed, black-haired young lady, who paused an impressive moment, assumed a tragic expression, and began to read in a measured, solemn tone.